Hi everyone, my name's Holly and I'm a food scientist. I've been a member of the Institute of Food Science and Technology since the beginning of my degree, and my love of food science came from being a food tech student just like you. So in this video, we'll be continuing the topic of conducting experiments. So what is a control? A control is a sample which has not been changed or altered in any way. It can then be used as a standard for other results to be compared against. So for example, if I grab an apple, and I cut it into equal segments, the control is just this, it is the standard. Then, to the other samples, I add the same quantity, so in this case, 5 milliliters of lemon juice, sugar water, cider vinegar, and apple juice. Now this is a fair test because the sample has been kept the same size throughout and it's only one variable that's been changed. And now you can measure how quickly the samples brown over time. If you want to try the same experiment again but changing a different variable, you could work with different varieties of fruit and vegetables, or you could work with fruit, for example, apple, but then different varieties of apple. So here we have Gala apple, Bramley apple, Golden Delicious apple, and Cox's apple. And within them, we can then measure which one goes brown the quickest. Other variables that you can change is monitoring with the fruit and vegetables over time periods. You could change the wrappings, for example, tin foil or cling film. You could also change the knife sharpness or different cutting tools. Another variable you can change is temperature. So you could have one at room temperature, one in the fridge, or you could even heat one. Sometimes you'll use a benchmark. This is like a control, but when you've achieved the perfect sample. You can use this benchmark and assess whether other samples meet the standard. This is very useful if you're doing experiments over several days. For example, you can make sure that your scones always reach the desired color. So you can also use color charts to assess the colors of different products. So here are my fair test top tips. Always have a control. Only change one variable at a time. Repeat where necessary. Measure all parameters accurately. For example, if you're measuring temperature, use a digital thermometer to measure temperature. Use a timer if you're measuring time. Use digital scales for weight and use beakers to measure volume accurately. Write clear notes and take pictures. Approach the investigation as you would a scientific experiment. Sometimes your investigations don't turn out the way you thought they should. Do you need to repeat your experiment to test it again? Is there something that could have caused it to go wrong? And how confident are you that your results are representative and accurate? And how can you check? So this is an experiment that I did with scones using different raising agents. This is what I expected to see, but in some trials I found that none of them rose, or I found that they rose into very odd shapes. This just highlights the importance of repeating your experiments. So in this video, we looked at browning of apples and the effect of different solutions on them. And then we also looked at the effect of different raising agents in scones, and these were measured against color charts. In our next video, we'll be talking about how to analyze our data and to make the most of our observations.